class, we have seen that on the seventh day, two things happened. And we have seen one thing, that all the servants packed their luggage and get ready to go. And the servant says, why is it Dr. Sadawa is an educated person and he knows what he ought to do. He knows what he ought to do. And Hana here asks Sadawa, even the illiterate servants knew what they ought to do. Why is it we cannot see clearly what we ought to do? What we ought to do, we have to hand over the prisoner to the police. Even the servants see more clearly than we do. Why are we different from other Japanese? Do we have any kind of a difference? Do we have any kind of difference from other Japanese people? Sadawa didn't answer. Sadawa was silent. But a little later, he went into the room where the prisoner was and said brusquely. Brusquely means rudely, roughly. So, after this question from Hana, Sadawa went to the prisoner and talked to him in a rough way. Today, you may get up on your feet. First command, today, you get up on your feet. I want you to stay up. Only 5 minutes at a time, physiotherapy started. On the previous day when he was trying to get up, he told, you should lay down. You should lay down. Today he says, today onwards, you should stand on your feet 5 minutes at a time. I want you to stay up only 5 minutes at a time. Tomorrow, you may try it twice as long. So today, 5 minutes at a time. Tomorrow, morning 5 minutes, afternoon 5 minutes. It would be well that you get back your strength as quickly as possible. So, it was an instruction given by the doctor to the patient to get himself ready to stand and walk. He saw the flicker of terror on the young face that was still very pale. So, when he told this to the prisoner, he could see a terror, he could see a fear on the face of the prisoner. Still, he told, okay, sir, okay, the boy murmured. Evidently, clearly, he was determined to say more. So when he said okay, he also determined, decided to say something more. He said, I feel I ought to thank you, doctor, for having saved my life. I feel that I should say thank you. I ought to say thank you. I am bound to say thank you, doctor, for having saved my life. Don't thank me too early. My dear boy, I have more work to do with you. The treatment is not yet completed. Further treatments are awaiting. So you say thank you at the end. Don't thank me too early, Sadhava said coldly. He saw the flicker of terror again in the boy's eyes. Then Sadhava looked. There was fear, flicker of terror, fear. There was fear in his eyes. Terror as unmistakable as an animal's eyes. The scars on his neck were crimson for a moment. Those scars, what are they? Sadhava did not ask. So he could see the scars on his neck, but he didn't ask the prisoner, he didn't ask the boy, he didn't ask the soldier the reason of that. In the afternoon, the second thing happened. Underline second thing. On right side you can write second two thing, thing number two. So first thing, servants packed their luggage. Here second thing had happened. Let us see what is it. Hannah, working hard on unaccustomed labor. So what is unaccustomed labor? Can you think? What you see, Hannah working hard on unaccustomed labor. What is unaccustomed labor here? Anyone? What would be the unaccustomed labor of Hannah that she was doing? Nobody. Anyone? Household jobs. Pune, yes, correct. Household job. Now I remember to tell you one thing. You see, in the last examination, some of the students are calling me and asking me, sir, what is the reason for me to lose the marks in MCQ? This is the reason that you lose the mark. You don't have an answer to reply. You don't have an answer to reply. Maybe one or two students are giving me the ready answers. Even I have asked you on which page we are, I would say there are only two or three people to answer here. Permanently, I noticed for last this many days. You are hesitant to answer. That is a very, very serious drawback from your side. You are good, but this is a very serious drawback, especially in the matter of English. This is the reason that you have lost the marks. Unless and until you try to respond, you will not get the reflexive thoughts, reflexive knowledge about the lesson. English doesn't give you the answer straight. You have to think about the behind the words. You have to think behind the words. You are becoming simply listeners. I ask a question at times wherever it is important that comes. This is a very negative remark about this. And you may say that I know it. Very, you don't know it. You don't know it. Sometimes you may be getting marks out of 30 or 30 in some other subjects, but you don't know it. That is why you have got marks, full marks in the last direct questions, name of the author, grammar questions. In the beginning also you have got, those who have got lesser marks, they got the marks in the last and first. In the middle I have inserted many indirect connotation based questions. You are unable to answer it. And in many questions I have given similar answers that are very, very close to the meaning. You will be get confused with the two answers if you don't attend the class in proper way, attending to the connotation or explanations that I give in the class. And you see, you may hear something right. And if you respond, then only you will be able to know my answer is wrong. You have to respond. Otherwise, what happens? Your wrong answer is there inside, and upon that, the correct answer comes. When you think this wrong and correct will make a shuffle, and you will be confused, and you are not sure with the correct answer. You are mixed with the wrong and correct answer. Once you respond, what happens? Your answer comes out. And you understand that this is a wrong answer. You pluck it out and then you insert the correct answer. So in your mind, there will be then correct answer only. This way I told you, not only in English, in all the classes you respond, tell out your answer, let it be wrong, no problem. Once you tell out, speak out the wrong answer, that is already gone from you. If it is correct, then you will cement it, you will not forget it. If it is wrong, you will pluck it out, then it will not be there. This is the reason many of you have lost a mark in the questions from 6 to 15 or 10 to 20 questions mainly. Question number 10 to 20, you have lost a mark. There I have inserted similar answers. The questions based on connotation. So when you learn, concentrate on the particular conversations. There are certain conversations with some connotations, particular names. So these kind of things you have to, some in particular conversation the meaning will be different. The question is like that, what does the author intend with this sentence in this particular area? When it is repeated in some other place, the meaning may be different. So in this particular portion, Sadhavo speaks as a doctor. On previous paragraph you have seen, what is the difference between us and the Japanese? Are we special Japanese? There the thought is based on patriotism, nationalism. But in the next moment, Sadao is acting as a pure doctor. So when he is behaving like a doctor, you have to read his sentence as a doctor. So this line of thought, fluctuation in the line of thought, difference in the line of thought in various places, you should be able to. That is why I told you, read the book. Then only you will be able to know where from this sentence is taken. Don't consider Sadao as a Japanese man in all the pages. He is different. Okay. So here, Hana working hard on unaccustomed labor. If you don't read it, you won't be able to know. The second thing may not be given to you in question, Hannah working hard on unaccustomed labor. If the first sentence is there, you will be able to know, isn't it? Second thing happened. You will be able to recollect. The first sentence will not be given, only the second sentence will be given, for which you should know the reading. So while she was doing, because she was not accustomed to do the household duties, okay Punya, she was not accustomed to do the household duties. There were servants. Servants were doing the duty. Now what happened? All the servants packed their luggage and they were ready to go. When they got up in the morning, they saw that now no work was done there. So she was compelled to do those household duties. That is why it is told, working hard on unaccustomed labor, saw a messenger come to the door in official uniform. Underline. Saw a messenger come to the door in official uniform. Underline. That is number two. Second thing happened. This will have a further reference. Remember this. It will have a further reference. Some of you might have heard this and they might have noticed it. Others simply heard it. When the reference comes, I will see that. This is some of you have such a mentality. And the reference come at that time, I will turn the page. It is said to click in your brain. So her hands went weak. She was shivering. Seeing the messenger, that means the messenger would be a police officer. Seeing the messenger, she was shivering. Why? The prisoner of war was in the room. So she thought that the police might have received the information about the presence of prisoner. So major or the general might have sent his people to investigate. That is why she was shivering. If so, Sadhava would be caught and he would be taken. That is why she was shivering. Her hands went weak and she could not draw her breath. She could not breathe. The servants must have told already. She thought the servants might have handed over the news to the police. She ran to Sadhava, gasping with a palpitation, unable to utter a word. She was much worried. But by then, the messenger had simply followed her through the garden, and there he stood. So the messenger did not speak a single word. He walked along the garden and he stood there. But by then, the messenger had simply followed her through the garden, and there he stood. She pointed at him helplessly. So she pointed at him helplessly. Sadhava looked up from his book. So Sadabo was reading in his room. Sadabo was reading in his room. And Hannah was unable to speak, spell a word. She could not speak. So she just pointed the messenger. At that time, Sadamo was reading a book from his, he took his eyes and looked at him. He was in his office. The other partition of which thrown open to the garden for a southern sunshine. So one side of the cabin was opened for sunshine. What is it? He asked the messenger, and then he rose, seeing the man's uniform. You are to come to the palace. This was the reply from the messenger. You are supposed to come to the palace of the general. The man said, the old general is in pain again. The old general is sick. You know, in the first page, we have seen that Sadabo was not given any transfer from that place because he was a famous expert surgeon. He was a very famous doctor, and the general was sick. We have seen in the first page. General was sick, and at that time it told him, told you, because of the selfish nature, or maybe innate selfishness, to get the treatment from such an efficient surgeon, the general did not give him any transfer. Now the same old general is sick. So he sent his messenger to call Sadao. Is it not enough? Sorry. Oh, Hana breathed. Now only Hana got some breath. Is that all? Anything more? Any other thing hidden? Is there anything hidden behind that? Is that all? This is the message. There is no other message. The messenger exclaimed, is it not enough? Indeed, it is. She replied, I am very sorry. Indeed, that is enough. I am very sorry. When Sadabo came to say goodbye, she was in the kitchen, but doing nothing. The children were asleep, and she sat merely resting for a moment. For more exhausted from her fright than from her work. Underline. She was more exhausted from her fright, fear, than from her work. So she was doing the unaccustomed work there. So she gets tired. But here she was sitting, resting. She felt tired, not because of her unaccustomed continuous work, but she was tired because of her fear, fright, that she felt when she met the messenger. I thought they had come to arrest you, she said. Sadao, I got afraid. I thought they might have come to arrest you. He gazed down into her anxious eyes. I must get rid of this man for your sake, he said in distress. Somehow I must get rid of him. Sadao was very much troubled at the fright of his wife. So he found that it is not so good to keep the soldier at home because it makes my wife distress. So he told, it is my duty as a husband. You see, here husband comes. Here the husband comes. As a husband, it is my duty to get rid of this unknown strange soldier who was not related to our home. You see, this strange unknown soldier is not related to us, but you, Hannah, you are more related to me the most. So in order to make you happy, I have to get rid of this unknown soldier. Clear now? I must get rid of this man for your sake. Sadamo goes to see the general. Of course, the general said weakly. So now the scene is changed. He is there with the general. I understand fully, but that is because I once took a degree in Princeton, so a few Japanese have. Princeton is a university in the US. So, of course, the general said weakly, I understand fully, but that is because I once took a degree in Princeton, so few Japanese have. So he told, he was in America also. He had taken a degree from Princeton University. I care nothing for the man, Excellency, Sadao said, but having operated on him with such a success. So there, he had already told the general about the soldier in his talk. So he says, I was also in America. So he says, I care nothing for the man. I don't have any personal impact. I don't have any personal touch with this man, with this soldier. But having operated on him with such a success. But it was unavoidable situation. As a doctor, I was supposed to help him. Yes, the general said, it only makes me feel you more ill than indispensable to me. I take care of you because I feel you are indispensable to me. You are a person whom I cannot avoid you. Indispensable, unavoidable. I cannot keep you away from you. I consider you one important part in my life. Evidently, you can save anyone. You are so skilled. Clearly, I know you can save anybody because you are that much skilled. You think I can stand one more such attack as I have had today. So you say that I can stand one more such attack, cardiac attack, I can withstand because you have told me. So I believe. If you have told, I have the assurance on that. I have the great assurance on your words because you are an expert, skilled doctor. I trust you. Not more than one, Sadao said. I have told only one more attack. I think that one more attack is already over now. Clear now. He reminded, General, Sir, Your Excellency is the respectful word used for the General. Excellency, Your Excellency. My Lord, Your Excellency, I have told only one extra attack. I think that is already over now. Then certainly I can allow nothing to happen to you. So certainly I wish that nothing happened to you. The General said with anxiety. His long, pale Japanese face became expressionless without any feeling, which meant that he was in deep thought. He was in deep thought. Underline, became expressionless. A question can come, what does it mean? What does it mean? You see, in deep thoughts, in deep thoughts. That is here, here, here. In this situation, deep thought. You see, understand, in this way, the questions can come. That is why I told you to read the book and don't try to read and complete the lesson with 1 hour. Don't do it. What I have told you, when you are tired, when you feel boredom, when you study other science and maths, you take my book and read for some time, 20 minutes. Did I tell you? This is the reading book for when you are free. Read 20 minutes. You read one paragraph, that is enough. In a day, I take maximum one page. Since it is a non-detailed book, I go a little farther. If it is the textbook, I didn't go more than one page. So I take that only. I take that part only. So when you take the book, read half an hour. Don't try to finish. In this way, you read and understand. When you read, you remember what all explanations were given when I was taking the class. You have to recollect. That is why I told you, you should write whatever things I tell in the class. Maybe I tell certain stories. You just note the story of Bash. Then you will recollect the particular situation I explained in the class. Okay, so he was in deep thought. You cannot be arrested, the General said, closing his eyes. Because I understand, I need you. I need your help. I am in danger. My health is in danger. In order to save my life, I need your presence. So, therefore, you cannot be arrested. You cannot be arrested. The General said, closing his eyes, suppose you were condemned to death and the next day I had to have my operation, then you write there, what will happen? Next, you write there, what will happen? You read that. General says, suppose, that is my term, I ask you, suppose, imagine, suppose you are arrested and you are punished, death penalty. You are condemned, punished for death penalty. And you are in the jail waiting for your death. Suppose on that day, if I get the next attack, what I will do, I will also die before your death, isn't it? So in order to keep my life on, I have to keep your life I have to keep your life safe. That is why I tell you, you will not be arrested. Clear now? Okay? Thank you. Here I end. We will see in the next class. Okay, thank you.